Hey guys, welcome back to the channel and welcome back to Roundtable Talk, where I dissect, analyse and review the latest releases as well as some old classics. So after much hype, DJ Khaled and Drake have finally dropped their new single. Well, it actually turned out to be two singles and I'm very excited to hear both of them. These two of course have an absolute catalogue of classic records together, and it's clear to me that, you know, Drake does definitely use Khaled tracks to run the summer, and you know, there's nothing wrong with that. Khaled obviously makes a lot of money off of it too, but yeah, he usually, you know, gives these tracks out to Khaled releases them to run the summer, and then Drake uses those the hype off those really to lead into his own album rollout. Pretty much any successful Drake and Khaled track is a gift from Drake and his production team to Khaled. You can tell that by, as I said, by the producers of each track. For example, I'm on one in 2011, produced by T-Minus. For Free, produced by 1985, I think in 2016. And No New Friends, of course, by Boy Wonder, I think in 2013. Those three producers are, you know, Drake producers, OVO affiliated, of course. And yeah, Drake's performance on all of these tracks are very much going for, you know, banger status. So again, as I said, I'm very excited to hear both of these tracks, because I think, you know, they're both going to be bangers. This is like to be the same sort of situation. Drake knows it's great marketing, he knows Khaled's going to, you know, build on the hype and build these things up, and it's a great way for him to release music that, you know, might be great but not fit the vibe he's going for on, you know, whatever album he is going to be releasing later this year, hopefully. So we're being blessed with two tracks produced by OZ, who also produced 2C Slide quite recently. I'm sure we're going to get two tracks with very different vibes, something that Drake usually does, not usually alongside Khaled, usually just with his own tracks. He released two tracks with two very different vibes to appeal to both sides of the audience, whether that's R&B and rap or pop and rap, and I feel like we're going to get two different vibes on this. I do know, of course, that quite a bunch, I think, of Drake tracks leaked a few weeks ago, including Grease. Thankfully, I managed to avoid listening to it purely for this video. So yeah, very excited to hear it. I know it's been getting a lot of hype as well. Looking forward to going in fresh and hearing these new tracks. But before I do, please do remember to subscribe to the channel, like the video, and follow me on all the social links below. And also, after the video, please do let me know your thoughts on the track as well. Let me know in the comments. But yeah, I'm not going to wait anymore. I can't wait any longer. Let's just dive in with the very first track called Grease.
DJ Khaled!
Come with me, leave all of your things, yeah. You can stop at Gucci, stop at Louis V, yeah. Fly you out to Greece, full speed, so volley Paris, yeah. Come with me, leave all of your things, yeah. You can stop at Gucci, stop at Louis V, yeah.
Okay.
Come with me, fly you out to Greece, full speed, so volley Paris. Waves in my ass, smoking weed, dipping through the sand in a jeep. All because of what I did on beats, baby. Life's sweet, baby. I ain't stop, baby. On time, looking for the bounce, yeah. Ozzy had to bounce, yeah. Come with me, leave all of your things, yeah. You can stop at Gucci, stop at Louis V, yeah. Come with me, fly you out to beef.
It's a hit.
Full speed, so full. Come with me, leave all of your things, yeah. You can stop at Gucci, stop at Louis V, yeah. Bags full of $100 bills. Pass your wife and she get chill. I get you anything you need, baby. Work for everything you see, baby. Ooh, wee, baby. Ooh, come with me. Leave all of your things, yeah. You can stop at Gucci, stop at Louis V, yeah. You can stop at Gucci, stop at Louis V, yeah.
Effortless for this
come
man.
Come with me. Fly you out to Paris. Full speed, so volley Paris.
I just have to go in on that.
Never falling, why you making problems? I've been silent, why you making problems? On out to Keiko, she can stay in my room. She can stay in my room, and it ain't mine. See me when I'm outside. She just wanna love me. She don't wanna leave me. She didn't wanna love me. She don't
wanna... Well, I'm glad I waited to listen to that track. How does this man do it? How can he keep doing this? 10 years in the game and just comes out and drops another hit. You can hear that song is a hit. Yeah, really enjoyed that. Like, worth the wait for me. Obviously, Khaled was bigging it up a lot. Obviously, I think it's pretty clear there's little bit of a Weeknd influence on Drake's vocals on that. His delivery sounds a little bit like Abel. Obviously also pitched up his vocals a little bit, so that's not Drake's natural voice. But yeah, it sounds good, and I appreciate the attempt from him to switch things up. I can't think of any kind of Drake song that sounds like Grease. Again, I'm talking about this as though it's a Drake song. Of course it's a DJ Khaled song, but as I said before, it's really a Drake song. Sound like there are a few quotables in there. I'm gonna listen to this song a lot, and I feel like this song's gonna get played a lot. But yeah, sound like there's a few quotables in there. Nothing like crazy. It's not lyrical Drake, it's, you know, pop Drake. But he just continues to smash it. Continues to absolutely dominate the game. Like, as I said, over a decade into his career now, there's no way that anyone ever has had this kind of run. It's just unprecedented, you know? Like, yeah, that was a bop. Where the drums drop in, interesting soundings, Middle Eastern kind of instrumentation in the background. That little breakdown towards the end was cool as well. I did feel like, you know, it could have used something towards the end to maybe take it up a level, but it's maybe not that kind of song. It's more just an absolute vibe, one of those ones you just ride to, and yeah, just a great song. Annoyingly, I just won't listen to that song again, but no, we've got another brand new DJ Khaled and Drake song, this one called Popstar. Yeah, let's see what we're gonna get with it.
Bitches calling my phone like I'm locked up nonstop. I'm a pop star, not a doctor. Bitches calling my phone like I'm locked up nonstop. From the plane to the fucking helicopter, yeah. Hey, shorty with the long text, I don't talk. Ay. Shorty with the long legs, she don't walk. I want a long life, a legendary one. I want a quick death and an easy one. I want a pretty girl, I'm a pop star, but this shit ain't bubble gun, yeah. You would probably think my manager is Scooter Braun, yeah. But my manager with 20 hoes and Budokan, yeah. Hey, look, Ariana, Selena, my visa. It can take as many charges as it needs to, my girl. That shit platinum just like all of my releases, my girl. Niggas come for me, I tear them all to pieces, my girl. And I'm not driving nothing that I gotta stick the keys in. Wonder how I got this way, I swear
that
I got
flies.
The bitches calling my bitches calling my phone like I'm locked up. Don't look like Kevin Costner, you tweaking. Just pulled up to Whitney, Houston, Texas for the evening. They tell the same story so much they start to believe it. The ones that start like Drizzy shit was cool, but we even. Hey, shit don't even usually get this big without a beeper face. Nah, piece of cake, nah, Turks and cake. Yeah, go and get your friends, we can sneak away. Yeah, I keep up like I keep the faith. Bitches calling my phone like I'm locked up.
Absolute slapper. Like, this man's versatility is unbelievable. How can you drop a track like Grease and then drop this absolute rap banger? Again, obviously not too much lyrical depth, but this is, you know, bragging Drake in his absolute bag. Reminded me straight away of If You're Reading This, It's Too Late, Drake. But at the same time, the way that he's playing with his flow in between those verses, I mean, again, just like Grease, but in a very different way. We've never really heard Drake sound like this before. And again, as I said, you know, to be this far into your career and to still be playing with new flows, new cadences, and to be doing it so well, again, it's just unbelievable. Obviously, it's gone on for a long time, so I think maybe we do start to take it for granted, but we're witnessing and have witnessed something very, very special with Drake's run of just releasing music, you know. And it's one of those tracks that I'm gonna have to and definitely want to listen to again, but a pure banger in terms of beat, but as I said, Drake's flow had this real urgent vibe to it. A couple of lyrics that maybe were references to Pusha T, I'm not too sure. And also, right at the start, something I noticed is Drake talking about death again, which is what reminded me of If You're Reading This, It's Too Late. When I do finally release my my revisit of If You're Reading This, It's Too Late, you'll see that that mixtape talks a lot about death. But yeah, absolute banger. Looks like DJ Khaled has got two hits on his hands again, courtesy of Drake. Fantastic songs. Two tracks that cover, you know, two different demographics pretty much. And they're just gonna absolutely dominate radio playlists, whatever. I'm very happy that those lived up to the hype, to be perfectly honest. I'm keen to finish this review now so I can listen to them again on headphones or something, because both of them absolute bangers. So yeah, that was my reaction to the new two DJ Khaled featuring Drake singles. Hope you enjoyed. Please do remember to subscribe to the channel, like the video, and follow me on the social links below. Really appreciate that. But apart from all that, please do stay safe out there, stay well, and make sure to join me for the next one. I'll see you there.